This is the vegan anarchist, and in this response video to respond video of my video, basically it's a respond video to AnarchoBlonde, shout out to him, to respond video to Black Hat, who's responding to me, so there's a lot of response. I'm also responding to Black Hat's response to me, so you know how it goes. So anyways, it basically is all of a response to my first video on why millennials wanting libertarian socialism. And I agree with AnarchoBlonde's point, and you should subscribe to him and everything like that, because he's great and he needs more subscribers. He's pointing out, I'm like, Black Cat, who's that tanky who made a response video, an ex-anarchist, he got on tanky. He just didn't get the nuance. He said at the end, you refute yourself because you say millennials prefer markets over big government. I'm like, yeah, but that's assuming that government is the means, the government is the way to get socialism. And he is a tankist, so he did state that. But the problem is he didn't get the nuance. I'm saying that you can want libertarian socialism like I do, but still prefer, free market capitalism to Stalinism. And yes, Stalinism is a thing, and I will refer to Black Hat, and all you and his supporters to AnarchoBlonde's video, which I'll put in the description after mine first, and then Black Hat's, and then AnarchoBlonde's third in order. So it is a thing, Stalinism is like hardcore Leninist, and not all Leninists are Stalinists. There's one YouTuber called Xerxes or whatever his name was. I can't pronounce it, who is a Leninist but rejects Stalinism. I might put a link in there, just FYI. And Trotskyites are a Leninist too, So, he's a hardcore Stalin supporter. It went over that. So, yeah, and he said basically that millennials are basically a bunch of liberals. And that's what I was saying. Yes, millennials are to watch by supporting Bernie Sanders and Jeremy Corbyn. If you watched the video, I made a point about that. But I was saying that when the reforms fail, Black Hat, that they're more likely to turn to libertarian socialism. Although a lot of them are also turning to the alt-right, which is a problem, okay? It's a big problem, and you gotta stop them, too. But the AnarchoBlonde, still a big shout out to him, said basically that there's a big millennial libertarian socialist anarchist movement. And he is correct, there is a big one. It's starting to fizzle up. And not only that, but if us anarchists and libertarian socialists promote our idea enough and work hard enough and work smartly enough, we could have a big revival of libertarian socialism so big it will make Occupy a fit, which is mostly liberals, with a little occasional libertarian socialism, and it failed because of liberals, because fuck liberals. It'll make it look like, look, it's just a miniature thing you'll be really care of. I refer to the article by, I forgot his name, you see my first video, it's based by, I can't remember his name, but basically, I did point it out, he didn't watch the whole video, and last part, he said anarchist was R word. I'm not gonna say the R word because it's ableist. If he knew the history of anarchism, not the history, the anarchist version, the anarchist telling, but the true history, he wouldn't be an anarchist. I respond, if Black Hat and those tankies knew the true history of the Soviet Union, Maoist China's communist regimes, or communists, not the bullshit that tankies teach you, but the actual history, they wouldn't be tankies, but they listen to bullshit. So I can easily flip that on you. basically, I'm doing this to say that I've been misinterpreted, and also finally, I know I said finally, but he made a comment about, oh look, he told me like he haven't read the anarchist. I told him, and I did tell him to hang out, I haven't read any of the anarchist, classical anarchist authors, but, and also because I don't like to read very much and things like that. And he said that, and he's like, if you can be an anarchist, do your reading. And first of all, I said, anarchism is a simple idea that doesn't require a rocket scientist to understand, or thousands of books, but yet so profound and genius that it's beyond belief. It's like one of those simple ideas that is like, why didn't I think of that? And he called anarchism many times idealism. I'm like, for most of human history, humans live in proto-anarchism, which they live very similar to an anarchist society. So and as many instances of actual anarchist, not proto-anarchist society, actually existing, taking off before being crushed. So it's not idealism, it's freaking worked before. Other hand, you know, Soviet Union collapsed, you know, he said, yeah, he brings up all anarchist failures collapse, but I keep saying the last point. But it's like, but he's like saying, oh look, anarchists fail all the time and we last longer than you, right? I'm gonna respond with, that is exactly what this is exactly like saying to a guy instigating a slave revolt in the Roman Empire to not do it because the Romans have crushed every single slave revolt and it will never succeed and Rome will never fall. Well, they're gonna overthrow Rome. Oh, Rome was overthrown. I'm sure something tried, but you know what I mean? It's like saying that. But things are different. Number one, it's a lot easier to be an anarchist. We have the internet. We have all these means of communicating to the rest of the world like this that they didn't have in Spain, anarchist Spain. We have a better educated population, so we would avoid some of the problems that the Russian Revolution has, which Bolshevik has, when I don't like them either, about the peasants and the workers being illiterate, not ill-educated. And we avoid, because most of the people are, well, not completely educated, at least they're fluent, they can read, okay? So I'll end on this note. I said end many times, but anyways, I'll end on this note. Yeah! Yes, a lot of millennials are liberals. They turn liberal. A lot of them turn to alt-right, which is also big libertarian socialists and anarchists seem to fizzling up. You know, once anarchy, it's very easy that if we do it right, struggle, all promotion, we can spread like wildfire and make the Paris Commune and revolutionary Catalonia look like a fucking coin, make them look like a irrelevant part of history. They're not irrelevant, but we make them look like, oh look, we make them look like a revolution. So tiny and insignificant comparisons, I'm saying. So this is the vegan anarchist. No meat, no milk, no masters. Fuck you, tankies. See ya. Fuck you, black cat. Oh, by the way, my psychiatrist told me to not talk, to hang out with you, black cat, because you stress me out too much. Anyways, this is the vegan anarchist. No meat, no milk, no masters. See ya.